Yeah, it's busted that boot clean in half, Les.
Yeah.
Clean in half.
Rod and Les have suffered a critical breakdown on their two-ton digger.
Well, that's not something I just have laying around, Les.
It's not.
Those teeth go into what we call boots that hold them in there. We've had that much pressure on the tooth that it's broken one of the boots in half. Oh, watch their fingers, Les. Watch your fingers.
Yeah, nearly broke two of them.
Well, you got. That's why they give you five of them. Oh, yuck. Oh, you old. You done that deliberate.
Oh. Where'd you get it caught?
Tooth dropped on it. Old thing.
It'll be up to Les to fix the digger tooth. With 40 years' experience as a rigger and 20 years spent collecting scrap at his yard, he's the ideal man for the job.
Last time you had that welder going here, it didn't end up real good, mate. So
it didn't.
Do not blow yourself up.
At the end of last season, Les suffered third-degree burns when a welding spark ignited a petrol canister.
I've got nothing around here to blow myself up with.
Yeah, well, that's good.
I learnt me lesson.
While you're doing this, you know how Amanda's been annoying us to go and get a goat for the sausages?
Yeah.
I might go and try and roll a goat while you're doing this, eh?
Yeah, righto. Yeah, not a problem.
All right, mate.
Righto, catch ya.
Living 70 kilometres from the nearest shop, Rod supplements his meagre food supplies with goat, a feral pest introduced to Australia over 200 years ago.
You live in the middle of nowhere, you know, like it's hard to get meat and stuff like that. There's heaps of it running around out here. I don't enjoy killing things, but I do enjoy eating.
Right through there.
Hey, they're good, eh?
Yeah. Goat curry with sweet chilli.
Oh, you ripper. Well, who'd ever thought you'd be here making bloody goat sausages, girl?
Oh, I know.
Hey?
Life is definitely different now than what it was when I was younger.
Until they met 23 years ago, Rod's wife Amanda lived a world away from the Opal fields.
My parents were motel managers and resort managers.
Gone from personal chefs to...
Wasn't a personal chef.
Did you or did you not have a chef?
Yeah, my dad.
No. Her parents thought she'd probably marry a millionaire or a... You know, someone important. When we got together, I guess it was a bit of a shock for everyone, you know, because, like, Amanda was very much a city girl back then.
When I first came out here, there were a lot of things I didn't like. See, I grew up with toilets inside, not out. Yeah, I used to go down the mine with Rod all the time. We worked good together.
Yeah.
You know.
I'm sure she's probably the best wife I've ever had. The old fella's got us out of trouble yet again.
Thanks to Les's supply of scrap metal, he's welded a new boot for the digger's claw.
Very good. Looks all right too.
Yeah, ready to go back underground.
We sort of got the old fella heading in the right direction now to be able to retire. So we just got to keep on digging. Just got to find it for him. Righto, Les, that's it, mate.
All right,
crank her up. Let's get in and find our fortune, mate. You ready?
Yeah, mate.
Man, that's hard.
Whoa, whoa! That looks a good piece. Got red and everything in it.
With their digger repaired, the Bushmen have finally hit promising opal trace.
This one's going to tell us whether we're rich or not. Oh, Les,
it,
Les,
it it come true?
I think it's gonna happen for us.
Oh, look at that! Look at the golds and the reds.
Haven't seen a piece that good for a long time.
It's got to be a couple of grand in that, Les.
Let's hope it continues, Les. Of course, that's big and it's cheesy.
I think you dropped a heap of stuff on the ground here, mate.
Hey?
Colour.
Oh, there's a bit, look.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Oh, that's all right. Oh, there's another bit. Pickle me grandmother, Les. Look at it.
Yeah. Whoa. That's good colour.
I tell you what, Les, when you look in this bucket, I reckon it'd have to be between 12 and 15 grand, wouldn't you?
Oh, I'd reckon, yes, because that's worth a fair bit in there.
I know Brian's kicking about. I might see if he's interested in this, eh?
Okay, yeah, that sounds all right, yeah. We're pretty low on money, so that pocket just coming in time.
Keen for a quick sale, the bushman arranged to meet local buyer, Brian Gray.
How you blokes going?
Hey, Brian does also do a bit of mining himself, but he got busted up pretty bad in a quad bike accident. So he's not been able to mine for a couple of years or do anything. All he does is buys and sells, put it on the wheel and polish it up and resell it.
Rod and Les have crystal opal in the rough. Its colours are varied, with attractive reds and yellows. Its weight, 650 grams.
Ah, geez, I'd have to have 14, 15 grand for them, so...
Their partnership deal will see them get 50% of the sale.
Negotiating with opal buyers is pretty much always the same. They're feeding the that want everything for nothing. That's why I got my lucky selling hat on.
Surprise me how much money you think of getting out of this
$22,000.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. Only because you're a good fella.
I'm about eight.
Come on now, let's get a bit fair dinkum here. Nice. Who are you talking to?
Little pieces like that, look at the colour in that.
I'll come down to 20.
Work with me here, you know, like.
Yeah, what do you reckon, Les?
18, Les. You happy to get 18?
Yeah, that doesn't sound too bad.
You come 18. Party.
And that's it, I'm not going any lower, so.
Will you take a check?
No.
No way. No. No way. Say 16.
No, let's say 18.
You're all right.
Right. 18.
18.
Good on you.
Where's
the problem, mate?
Well, I didn't think we were going to get that much. I thought a few bucks less, but no, 18 grand was good.
It's a special deal this week. There's some sausages for you.
Some sausages as well.
Goat sausages, wild goat sausages,
Jesus
mate.
Christ. Wild goat sausages.
Hi, mate.
Not a problem, mate.
Thank you for that, and we'll catch you later on.
I got a little bit more than I wanted, so I was real happy with it.
Nigel.
Les and Rod's share of $9,000 brings their total at the season's halfway mark to just over $50,000.
Just going to keep us floating for a little bit longer, but we're pushing hard to find that big pocket.
That's getting better.
I want to send Les off all right, you know. He's got to be starting to take it easy.
It's there somewhere, and we'll get it.